this week you learn an actual skill. Ha ha, didn't see that one coming.
This episode of Scam School brought to you by Domain.com.
Welcome to the show with tricks so good we could start a cult. If we weren't so damn lazy, drunk, procrastinating. Scam School, the only show dedicated to social engineering at the bar and on the street. Hello, beautiful people, I'm Brian Brushwood, and this week you're gonna learn some actual sleight of hand. Get ready to practice and be playing with cards all the time.
Yeah. All right, ready? Boom, 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 boom. Boom! Hey, look at that, nice.
First time Scam School has been here at the Buzz Mill off of what, Riverside? Is that what we're close to in Austin?
Yes, sir.
We got Nick, good to see you.
Good to see you.
John, who works with me for 2.5 years and finally on the show. And JR, of course, good to see you again. All right, here's what I want to do. I'm going to show you my favorite version of this card trick, and then I'm going to teach you the simplest version that I know how to do.
Rumble!
Yeah, yes. Let's do it.
Do you want to shuffle the cards or you just want to pick one?
I'll just pick one.
Yeah, it doesn't matter. Whichever one you want. Write your name on that card. Write it nice and big, and I want you to turn it face down.
Okay.
Fair enough? All right, Aaron, just say stop whenever you want.
Stop.
There we go. Good enough. Perfect. Burp, 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 burp. And do you know how to shuffle a deck of cards?
Yeah.
Okay, here's what I need you to do. I need you to shuffle those up. Make sure you're absolutely certain that there's no way I can know the order of those cards, okay?
All right.
Before I even left for the bar today, I made a prediction, and I put it right here in my wallet. I'll bet you the contents of my wallet that I got it right. Okay, I'm going to put that right there so there's no way I can get it. Fair enough?
Fair enough.
We're going to start off with the color. I want to know if it's a red card or a black card.
Black card.
Black card, all right. I feel like I got this right. You satisfied those are totally mixed up?
Yes.
Okay, awesome. Nothing I could do. I've made my prediction. You selected your card, you signed it. Into my wallet, I put one prediction card. The one you picked was what?
Four of spades.
And did you feel like I influenced you in any way or you had a totally free choice?
Full choice.
Because the card that I predicted before this even began was the four of spades with your signature on it.
All right.
Did you like that?
What? Yes.
This one's a little more advanced. This is something called the Rogue's Wallet that we have available at Scam Stuff right now. But I'm gonna teach you a simple version that looks pretty much the same that you can do with nothing special. Here, toast me, gentlemen. Let's learn some magic. Some skills. Woo!
My name is Bloom, and I'm a retired Slenderman. You probably couldn't tell from my civvies, though. Grew out my hair, too. I just couldn't take the lifestyle anymore. I always wanted to be a forest preservation activist, but nobody trusts us Slenders. But that'll change with Domain.com. Now I don't need a suit to get the kind of credibility .coms and .nets provide. You can even get 15% off with promo code SCAMSCHOOL. I'm looming with joy. Hello, Scaler.
All right, the card to impossible location is a classic of magic, and there's a bunch of different ways to do it. In this case, we developed the Rogue's Wallet in conjunction with Peter Nardi and Alakazam Magic in the UK. This exact same effect I learned when I was like 8 years old, and it was unbelievably simple. Here, I'm gonna do it again for you, JR. Here, do me a favor, buddy, just touch any one card. All right, you want that one?
Yep.
All right, the same thing, go ahead and write your name on it. Don't let me see it.
All right.
All right, here we go. Just say stop.
Stop.
There we go. Put that in there. Who cares? I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to have you shuffle the cards. All right, now when you shuffle them up, again, same deal. Just let me know once you think they're totally shuffled.
Got it.
You happy? All right, go ahead and put it right here. Awesome. Now the question is, there's two ways I can do this trick. I can slap it or I can snap it. Which one do you want?
Slap it.
All right, get ready. Here it comes. Here comes the slap. What was it?
Eight of hearts.
Yeah, there we go. The eight of hearts right there on top, right? Okay, there's a bunch of different ways to control cards. You can pay attention to stuff. You can move it to the top. You can move it to the bottom. We did a whole episode on controlling cards. It's called Controlled Cards. There'll be a link down below. But the easiest way is to take their card out while they shuffle up the deck. Let's start with the basics of palming cards. Everyone take a card. We're gonna learn how to palm it and not look like a goofball. Here's the problem what everyone does is they get so nervous, they put the card in their hand and they practically ball it up into a fist and they hide it back like this, like they got something to hide. The more of that you do, the more suspicious you're gonna look and also the more obvious your bent ass card is gonna be, right? So instead, we're gonna learn how to handle it with finesse. In this case, you wanna have kind of two points of contact, your pinky and the pad right beneath your thumb. You should be able to hold it just on those two points. You got it? You got it? See, you got it? You got it? You got it? Now, don't worry about these windows being able to see through it all. Second of all, you want to relax everything. Michelangelo was a genius of drawing hands because he knew to keep your fingers curved naturally. People think that you got to have it, you know, super flat or something like that. Don't worry about that either. So you're going to have those two points of contact, and then just drop it. Let it casually rest by your side. And now if you do it right, you can notice you have a perfectly natural, smooth hand, and it'll naturally rest in there. And the good news is nobody should be looking at your hands. If you're really nervous, you can rest them up on the table. You can rest them on your side if you want. If you're seated, you can rest them on your thigh. There's plenty of ways to cover this up because nobody should suspect, let alone detect, what you're doing. You just have to worry about how do you get their card into your hand. Now, as I said, we've already taught like a million different ways to get their card to the top of the deck. Go look at the other episodes. But once their card is on the top of the deck, all you need to do to get it in position is if you push it ever so slightly forward, when you rest your hand on it and you put your pinky right on that top corner position, this will act as a lever and the fulcrum will just pop it right in there. It'll lever straight in, grab the deck, hand it to them. Now this is terrifying to do because you're convinced they'll know. Hand it right to them and then go to your resting position. Now look at this resting position. There's no way for you to see the card. It's completely hidden underneath this hand. You have a job to do. You're busy shuffling up those cards while I'm making casual conversation. When you're done, this is my favorite part. You finally shuffled the cards, and I tell you to set them right here. I say, we can make that magic happen one of two ways. I can slap it, or I can snap it. And during that time, now you remember that you were given a choice, and you're like, well, of those two, I think slapping it seems fishier, so I'll go with snapping it. But it doesn't matter, because I just set it right on top, and then snapped it, and then there's their freaking card. One more time, where should the cards be located on your hand?
Between your pinky and the palm of your hand.
That's right, that's right. And then give it a little natural curve. There you go. And you don't want to bow the card too much. This is weirdly one of those tricks where the crappier the deck of cards is, the better it's going to look because it gives camouflage to any creases or folds you accidentally do. All right, Nick, what do you do to get it into this hand?
Push the card slightly forward.
Yep.
Drop it down.
Drop it down.
Lever it right up, and you got it. Here, you show me this time. You're gonna push it about a quarter inch forward, and take your time on it. There you go, you got it. Did it go? And it goes right into position, right?
Right there.
Now hand me the deck of cards with that hand. People are tempted to palm with this card and then just do this. That reads, everyone's like, what's he hiding back there? But if you hold it right underneath them, they can't resist, but like, oh man, that's gotta be fair. That's great, and if you want to cover it, anytime you're worried about misdirection, all you have to do is look them in the eye and ask a meaningful question. You just say, JR, don't lie to me. And the people are like, wait, what? And we're like, when's the last time you went to the bathroom? And you're like, I don't know. It doesn't matter because you're engaged. You're not watching this business happen down there. All right, so the only question remains is which one of you guys is going to perform it for me?
JR. Sure. I'll do it.
Boom, boom, boom. All right, so we lost Nick. He had like real life important stuff to do, but it doesn't matter. I'm gonna see JR do the trick for me. What's up, buddy?
How's it going?
Oh man, I'm
you ready.
I'm ready to have my mind blown.
All right, go ahead and pick a card.
That one right there.
All right, go ahead and write your name on that.
Boo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo. Now what?
All right, go ahead and put that on top for me. Save me the trouble.
All right, there you go. You're all set.
Brian, do you know how to shuffle cards?
Yeah, of course I do. Why?
All right, go ahead.
Oh, shuffle cards.
Yeah.
This is how lazy
they
are.
Show me all of the trouble.
He didn't even want to do it. I lost a card there. That's how bad I am. All right, it's got to be somewhere in the middle. I shuffled it real good. And I'll give it a cut. Boom. Now
right.
What?
Slap it or snap it?
You know what? I want to slap it.
I will slap it. All right. What was your card?
It was the one that I drew a circle all over.
Was it the Jack of Spades?
Oh my God!
What?
It's amazing! Look, man, this is only the beginning. Once you learn to palm a card, you can do pretty much anything. It's freaking amazing. There's a million different methods, and you can learn a whole bunch more by heading over and checking out our advanced tutorials at scamstuff.com. You can learn the side steal, the one-handed top palm, all kinds of crazy variations, and then put those skills to use with the Rogue's Wallet. It's the best thing we've ever released at ScamStuff. Head on over there right now. Now, don't forget to join us next week, because we're going to learn the amazing secrets of teleporting beer into your mouth. It's called a straw. Who drink beer out of a straw? What was your card?
Four of
spades. Four spades?
I think so. Spades or clubs.
I remember it was a black card. What?
And go.
That is my real signature. I'm sorry. Don't lie to me. When's the last time you went to the bathroom? It's everyone's like, what's he hiding back there? I'm ready to have my mind blown out.